What up, what up? Winbush here. And the number one thing I've been getting asked ever since they added VDB support to Unreal Engine 5.3 is how exactly do you render this out? So without further ado, let's jump right into it. But before we move on with the video, I want to give a special shout out to today's sponsor for sponsoring this video, which is Eskar. They make these really dope wallets. As you can see right here, I have the aluminum one. And the cool thing is, like, I like carrying my wallets in my front pocket. And this is my original wallet. You can see that it's actually half the size and it's super slim. And if you know me, I'm all about tech. And the cool thing is, look at this. It actually holds up to 12 cards in here and they just slide up like so. So this is the aluminum one, but I also have a leather one as well, which is called the Parliament, like this one right here. So you can look inside, I have my money right there. Actually, I have my own personal cards inside there as well as my driver's license. And they did come with this tracker as well. If I pull this out like so. So this is actually a tracker that slides into the back of your wallet. And since they are sponsoring this video, I was actually able to get them to give me a 25% discount if you guys want to purchase it. All you have to do is use the code Winbush on checkout and you'll be able to save 25% immediately. Or you can click on the link down below inside the comment or inside the description and it will take you automatically to where you can get that discount. So as you can see, I'm in Unreal Engine 5.3 right now. I have a tornado that we got from Embergen. You can download that free, the VDB set. So I'm going to actually come here, just hit F11, come out of full screen. And now you can see I have everything already set up down here. So if you want to see how to set up this VDB, make sure you go to my channel. I have two videos on how to set this up. But what I'm going to do is actually come up here to where we have this clipboard. I'm going to come down here to where it says add level sequence. And then I'm just going to add a sequence. And so I could just name this one tornado render, hit save. And now we have our sequence down here. And then I'm going to click on, I'm not even sure how to say this still. I'm just going to call it the H volume. I'm going to left click, drag this into here. And this is what's going to be holding our VDB. Now these next couple of steps are really important. So make sure you pay attention to what I'm about to tell you. So with my tornado going right now, if I select it right here under H volume, let me scroll up in the details panel. You can see right here, my frame rate is 24 frames per second. So whatever you made your VDB in that frame rate, make sure you have it selected right here. And I have my end frame at 127 frames. So if I come back to my sequencer, you wanna make sure that your frame rate right here coincides with your frame rate right here. So we're working at 24 frames per second. And then down here, you wanna make sure you have enough frames. So let me come over to, let me just move this out to about 127, somewhere around here. I'm going to hit the right bracket down here just to make sure it fills up the entire length. Now over here where we have our volume on the left hand side, I'm going to hit the plus symbol, and then I'm going to come over here under components to where it says volume component right here. So if I left click on this, now it's going to bring up a sub right underneath there where it says volume component. Now if I click on a plus symbol here, actually let me go to the very first frame, and then I'm going to click on the plus symbol right here. And where it says animation, I want to come right here to where it says frame. So if I left click on this, now you can see down here, it has frame, but it's off right here. So we don't want to start at 109. And it did that because our current animation is currently on loop. So if I come over here, make sure you click on H volume, where it says playing, I'm going to turn this off, turn off looping. And then down here, or actually up here where it says frame, I'm going to make sure it's reset. So it's at zero. And then back over here inside of my sequencer, I'm just going to lay down a keyframe at zero. Now I'm going to go all the way to the end. So actually this should be at 127 right about there. Let me move over my end bracket. So maybe I'll go up to 128, hit the end bracket. Now I could come back to 127, and down here where it says frame, I'm going to type in 127. Now that's going to bring up a keyframe here. And if you notice, if I come through and play this through, it looks a little bit weird, right? And that's because it's actually ramping up and it's ramping down. And so these frames are actually going to be kind of weird. So you're going to get that type of movement inside of there. In order to fix that, what I'm going to do, come back to my first frame. I'm going to select both of these keyframes down here. Then I'm going to right click, and right here where it says linear, I'm going to left click on this. Now when I play this through, everything should play smooth. There's no ramping up and there's no ramping down. So whenever we go to render, everything should just play back nice and smooth for us. So the next step from here, actually, as always, you want to save all. I'm just going to save everything here. Come back to my sequencer and we're just going to add a camera. Now with my camera added, you can see it added the camera cuts. And so by default, this is what we want right here. Just going to drag these out a little bit, select my camera. And I'm actually just going to pull back here a little bit so we see the entire tornado. If I wanted to, we really don't need like any type of focus on here. So just going to come over, disable focus, make sure everything's in focus. And now we're ready to render. So I'm going to come over here to where I have my clipboard. Come over here, the movie render queue, click on settings. Maybe let's just do something like a QuickTime, Apple ProRes, something like that. Just going to leave it at default. Make sure everything looks good. So I'm just going to render HD right there on my desktop, 24 frames per second. Nothing too crazy. So now I'm going to hit accept. Then I'm going to come down here, render local, and let everything play out. And it was easy as that. So there were some steps in there that you made sure that you needed, like making sure you have your keyframes at constant, because I know that's going to get a couple of people mixed up there. You don't want it to ramp up or ramp down, because then that's going to make your frames mix up there. Think of a VDB as just an image sequence, so everything must be exact. So hopefully this helped you guys out. If it did, as always, leave me a comment down below. Subscribe to the channel if you're new, and make sure you stick around for some more tutorials that I'm going to be releasing on my channel. And until next time, stay fresh, keep creating, and I'll catch you in the next video. I'll see you soon. Take care.